Hello everyone, welcome back again. So today's video is about image manipulation in Python. So there is a library called Pillow, which everyone uses for image manipulation. But I found that image manipulation using Pillow is kind of hard for beginners because it's actually very complicated if you don't know how things are working. So I decided to make a wrapper of Pillow and make an easier version of that, so beginners also can edit images. So in this video we will explore the library, and in next videos we will learn how to use that. Like we can also use this to create your own custom Discord rankers and the way you want. Actually no more using templates or whatever. So let's explore the library. First of all, let's see. If you want to use the library, you have to install it. So its name is actually easy-pil. So pip install easy-pil. So if you do this, easy-pil will get installed. Because this is easy version of pill, so this is easy pill. Okay, I have some images here like the PG and the PFP. We will use this to make Discord rankers, but let's explore the library first. So from easy pill, there are many classes like the editor, canvas, font, and some utility functions. Let's just import editor. So after importing editor, we have to make an instance of it. So let's create an editor, and what image we want to actually edit here, we have to pass either an image or path to the image. So we will, for now, will not edit any image, we will just create an image. To create an image, we can just import canvas, and we'll create a canvas, and its size will be 900 by 300, and let's do its color to black, but it will support like RGB colors or hex colors also. After that, the canvas is ready, so we will edit that canvas. Okay, so if we just do the show method here and Python main.py, you can see the canvas we created is 900 by 200 canvas. Okay, so we don't need the show here. Let's edit this one. So what can we do using this editor? Using this editor, we can like make the corners rounded of anything like images. We can add texts into it, you can add circles, we can do many functions. Let's see. First of all, let's create a rectangle into the canvas. So editor dot, actually after creating this canvas we don't actually touch it because we passed it in our editor, so editor will have that canvas. So you can just do editor dot rectangle. Okay, so in the rectangle you have to pass many things, like you can see position, width, its height, its fill color, its outline, and stroke width, also radius. So let's just create a rectangle in, let's see, 100 by 100 or maybe 150 its width. So 100 by 150 it will be like, let's comment this one out. So if we want to create a rectangle 100 pixel from the right and from the top. So if I pass the position 100 by 100, the rectangle will start from 100 pixel from the left and 100 pixel from the top. So we passed 150, so it will go from x-axis 100 pixel from top, it will go 50 pixel. Then we have to pass the width of the rectangle, so let's see 600 pixel, and the height will be maybe 30 pixel, let's say 40 pixel. Fill color, let's put white, and no outlines. So that's it. If we now run this, and you can see we created a rectangle. It's gone 100 pixel from the left, then 150 pixel from top, and then its width is 600 pixel and height is 40 pixel. So that's how we draw a rectangle. So if we want a radius, so radius equals to, let's say 20. So 20 radius means it will get curved. So that's the amount of radius. We can also reduce it. Let's close this one, and you can see the radius is smaller. So you can pass whatever radius you want. Then we can also you can see we just passed here the fill color, but if we say outline is equals white, so it will have no fill, but it will have an outline. If you think the outline is much thicker, so you can just make it more, stroke it, and let's say 5. By default it's 1, so you can see 5 is much more fat, and we can pass other like 100. Let's see what it goes. You can see the stroke is 100 pixel and not looking bad because its height is 40, but we're passing 100 stroke. That doesn't make any sense. Let's say 2. Okay, so 2 is looking good. You can choose whatever you want. So that was rectangle. Let's remove rectangle, and now let's create a circle. So for circle we have to use the ellipse function, and again the coordinates. So let's say 100 pixel from left, 150 from right, then the circle will be 100 pixel by 100 pixel, width 100 pixel, height 100 pixel. Then fill color will be, let's say white, let's put red here, and that's it. If we now run this, you can see this circle. If you want to put it on the top, you can also do that by just putting 0 and 0. You can see here, so it's now from left 0 pixel, from top 0 pixel. Next is, we can also, if we just put fill with outline and run this one, you can see now it don't have a fill but outline. Then you can also pass the stroke width here like 5, so it will have a 5 stroke width, you can see. So that's how you use ellipse. Next is let's just click on dot, and you will see all the other functions like resize, rotate. Let's use this rotate one. So rotate, then how many degrees you want to rotate it. Like if we wanted to rotate 30 degrees, we rotated it 30 degrees. Let's see. You can see it's not looking good because we didn't expand it. Let's do that, expand using true. So you can see it has been rotated 30 degrees. We can also do like 90 degrees or horizontally. You can see we rotated it. Okay. After rotating, we can also use the rounded corners here, and radius equals 10, so you can also make the rounded corners using that function. And this will not just using that radius attribute, but we have a function also, and also we can make images rounded. We will see that later. So that was rounded corners, but now let's remove this and see how can we paste text here. So for text, we have to put the text, and we have to know the coordinates where we want to paste the text. Let's say we want it 0 and 0, from top 0 and then from left 0. Then the text will be hello world, and let's say color equals red. So if we just run this, you can see we have hello world here, but it's actually looking too small. For bigger sizes, we have to use a custom font, and for that easy-pil also provides some font. So we have some fonts like Poppins, so here is our Poppins font. We just loaded it from font, and if we use this font here and if we run this, you can see the font of the hello world text has been changed. And the fun part is we can also set size here like 30 pixels. You can see the text has been increased by 30 pixel, and also it has a variant, like variant you can choose regular, bold, italic and light. Let's use light. You can see it has been it's lighter than previous one. And if we just use bold and run this, you can see the text is bold. And also there is a beautiful font like caveat. It actually looks good, like handwriting or something. You can see the font. And also you can use your own custom font. Let me show you how. So for that, let's go to Google Fonts. Choose whatever font you want to use. Let's say we want to use this one. Let's download the family and extract here. Where it gone? Okay, palette mosaic, and you can see this font. Let's just drag it and put it in assets. Rename it. Okay, so we have the font inside assets folder. So we can now just use, we can just pass the path asset slash and the font name is palette.ttf, so we can just copy its name like this, and let's put a size like 30 pixels maybe. Okay, so we can now, we just now have the font here. So palette, let's see if it works or not. You can see now we are using the palette font. It's actually very good. So you can download any font paste it in the folder and you can just use it right away. There are many fonts, whatever you like, just download like this one. If you want to this, we can just go here, download this, unzip it, copy the font, and then pass the path here, and then what size you want. You can have multiple fonts like this, maybe 20, and name it palette small. And we have now a small font and big font. Let's say we want another text in below that, 50 pixels below, and hello world. Let's put that text and name, and the font is palette small. So we are pasting two text, and one is hello world and it has the 30 pixels size and then 20 pixels. If we don't run this, you can see this is 30 pixels, this is 20 pixels. So we have two text, and this position is actually, you can see, let me show you again, from left 0, from top 50, and this is from left 0, from top 0, and there is a gap between the text even though it's 0, because it's the font's height. The font has an extra padding on top, that's why it's pushed a bit below. Okay, so these are the functions. Now let's see if we can paste an image here, like this PFP image here. If you want to paste this inside our canvas, okay, so for that we have to just, so PFP is equals to editor, and then pass the path of the image. Okay, we have the image. Now if we just do editor.paste, and then we have to specify the image. The image is this PFP, so PFP.image, and then we have to pass the location, let's say 50 by 50. So we will paste the image from top 50, from left 50. You can see it has been pasted from left 50, from top 50, but the image is too big, so let's just resize it. Resize it 100 pixel by 100 pixels. You can see the image has been resized 100 pixel and it has been here. So also you can just do circle image, so image, the image will become circular, you can see. And let's put it like 100 100. So this is now here. That's how you can paste images. Also, you can, now I have shown all the functions that this provides. Now you can actually use them to make your own rank cards, and in the next video I'll show you how can you use this to make rank cards. Like let me show you from Google. We will take example from Google, any card you want. Whatever, actually there are many rank card examples here. You can see like this one looking good. If you want to make like this, I will show you how you can make this in the next video. Till then, tata.